A loaded Glock pistol that is ready to be fired is referred to as being in battery, meaning that there is a live round in the chamber and the hood of the barrel is fully engaged in the slide's ejection port. At this point, the slide and barrel are in their fully forward position. Also, at this state of readiness, the rear lug of the barrel is on the metal locking block, and the extension on the front lug of the barrel is engaging the horizontal groove of the slide lock, which locks the slide and barrel in place. The slide and barrel are held in their forward position by the recoil spring assembly, the front end of which engages the guide ring of the slide, and the rear end of which engages the rear face of the dust cover, the hollow forward section of the frame. When all these elements are in position, the firing cycle can take place. When the finger is placed on the trigger safety, which is on the face of the trigger, very little pressure will cause the back of the trigger safety to pivot into a slot in the rear of the trigger. This action will disengage the trigger safety, and the trigger can be pulled rearward. As the disengaged trigger safety clears the frame, the trigger bar will also start to move to the rear. Near the end of the trigger bar is a cross-shaped configuration, which is referred to as the cruciform. As the trigger bar moves rearward, the end of the cruciform is engaging the lug of the firing pin. The part of the cruciform that engages the lug of the firing pin is bent upward and is referred to as the kick-up. This engagement causes the firing pin to move rearward with the trigger bar, compressing the firing pin spring as it does so. This will eventually fully cock the pistol, which up to this point was only partially cocked. At the same time, as the trigger bar moves rearward, the vertical extension of the trigger bar contacts the firing pin safety. The vertical extension will cause the firing pin safety to move upward, compressing the firing pin safety spring. This will disengage the firing pin safety by pushing it up into the slide, unblocking the firing pin channel and allowing the firing pin to move freely. Another occurrence as the trigger bar moves rearward is the rounded end, or bird's head, of the trigger bar coming in contact with the raised angled edge of the connector. The raised angled edge will change the trigger bar's movement from rearward to downward. At this point, the trigger bar will have moved far enough to the rear to automatically disengage the third and final safety, the drop safety. Once the drop safety has been disengaged, the trigger bar will have moved downward to the point where the kick-up is disengaged from the lug of the firing pin. All three safeties have been disengaged, and the firing pin is free to move forward. Once released, the firing pin is forced forward by the compressed firing pin spring. This will cause the nose of the firing pin to protrude through the firing pin hole in the breech face, contacting the primer of the chambered round and firing the pistol. When the cartridge is fired, the primer ignites the powder in the cartridge, and the rapidly expanding gases force the projectile through the barrel. Newton's third law says, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. The equal and opposite reaction in this case is the recoil energy, which will drive the slide and barrel rearward. The slide and barrel move rearward together for a very short distance, until the rear barrel lug drops off the locking block. This causes the barrel to drop down and stop, while the slide continues its rearward movement. By the time the barrel drops down, gas pressure has been reduced to a safe enough level to permit the extraction and ejection process. As the slide moves rearward, extraction and ejection of the fired casing takes place. Extraction is the result of the hook of the extractor pulling the fired casing out of the chamber. Ejection takes place when the fired casing comes into contact with the ejector, which expels the casing from the pistol. While the extraction and ejection process is happening, the slide is driven all the way rearward, and the recoil spring is fully compressed. The recoil spring will now drive the slide forward. As it is driven forward, the stripper rail on the bottom of the slide will engage the top round in the magazine. This round will be pushed up the feed ramp and into the chamber of the barrel, which is still in the dropped position. The breech face of the slide will now come in contact with the hood of the barrel. As the barrel is pushed forward, the rear lug of the barrel slides up on the locking block, and the hood of the barrel moves up into the ejection port. The slide and barrel have moved together, to the point where the rear lug of the barrel is on top of the locking block, the hood of the barrel is fully engaged in the ejection port, and the trigger is reset as follows. As the slide starts moving to the rear, the hook of the connector is pushed inward by the cam of the slide. A small hump on the rear underside of the slide, no longer held down by the raised angled edge of the connector, the trigger bar is now free to move upward. Under tension from the trigger spring, the trigger bar pops up so that the lug of the firing pin can engage the kick-up end of the trigger bar as the slide moves forward. This action drives the trigger bar forward, resetting the connector, the trigger, and the trigger safety. To better understand this function, a right side detail view of the connector reset clearly shows the relationship between the connector and the trigger bar as the slide moves forward. The firing cycle is now complete, and the pistol is back in battery. For more information, chat live with our experts now.